What's up, guys? So the topic of self-care in private practice has come up so many times in my personal life and hearing from you all that I know I'm long overdue to talk about it in a video. So in this video, I'm going to share my top tips for prioritizing self-care while working in private practice. Welcome to Private Practice Skills. I'm Dr. Marie Fang, psychologist in private practice. I post videos offering tools I learned the hard way about starting and growing private practice so that you don't have to. Okay, so first, let's be clear about what I mean when I say self-care, because I think so many of us have the impression that self-care means going to the spa, going on vacation, and though I could totally use a vacation right now, when I'm referring to self-care, I'm referring to something so much bigger than those self-pampering moments. At its core, self-care is about taking a conscious, active role in prioritizing our well-being and improving our overall health. So it naturally follows then that prioritizing our self-care while in private practice involves asking what it is that we need in order to prioritize and improve our well-being, and then taking active, intentional steps to move towards that. Here's the thing, if you only take away one thing from this video, it should be this. I think so many of us pursue self-care in completely the wrong way. We have this idea that we work ourselves hard into the ground until we're exhausted, and then self-care is all the work that we do to sort of undo that exhaustion. Though there's absolutely a place for that, and I too need my R&R after a really long workday, I think the best tips that I have for prioritizing self-care in private practice are building a work-life balance such that by the end of the day, you aren't feeling so exhausted. So here are my top tips for practicing self-care in private practice. Number one, finding a niche. Now you might be thinking, I thought finding a niche was all about having a great marketing strategy, and though that is also true, and I have an entire video all about that, I've noticed that working within my niche has really helped energize me in my practice, because by working exclusively with clients within my niche, I know I'm always enjoying the work that I'm doing. These are people that I really love working with. And so most of the time, by the end of a session with a client, I'm feeling more energized than I felt going into the session. Number two, set firm boundaries. Now, I've found that most of the time when I start to find myself feeling tired while I'm working with a client, there's a good chance that I'm letting one of my boundaries slide. So whether it be that I'm not ending my sessions on time, we're communicating through email too much in between sessions, or somehow I'm just working harder than my client, I tend to start getting really tired when I let my boundaries slide. So by having a good sense of what boundaries you need to set and then sticking to them, you can really practice self-care well in private practice. Number three, charge what you're worth. I can't emphasize this tip enough. I mean, I could be doing all the other tips on this list, but if I was undercharging, I would definitely head towards burnout real fast. So make sure you're charging what you're worth, because not only does that validate the value of your work, but it also allows you to work less while earning the same income or maybe more income. Tip number four, find support. And I'm talking all kinds of support. Working in private practice can have a tendency to become pretty isolating if we're not intentional about finding the right supports. So make sure you find the right consultation groups, make sure you have loved ones who are on board and understand the nature of the work that you do, and make sure you also have a low threshold for when you decide to go get some of your own personal therapy. I know for me, all three of these items make a huge difference in how I experience the work that I do, and when I feel well supported from all sides, then I feel very cared for, and I don't feel like I have to sort of go back and do all this extra self-care in order to feel rested. An added benefit of having great support is that our loved ones can notice when we're headed in an unhealthy direction, often before we can catch it. And if they point it out, they can gently remind us to head in a healthier direction before it goes too far. And of course, as always with all of my videos, there are way more tips for how to practice self-care well in private practice. But I've found that if I'm implementing these four tips well, that most days I'm coming home filled with joy and feeling energized rather than feeling exhausted at the end of the workday. Well, I hope you found these tips helpful as you practice self-care in private practice. Let me know in the comments what tips you have for practicing self-care well. And until next time, from one therapist to another, I wish you well. In order to prioritize and improve our well-being.